Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to a special roundtable discussion. And first and foremost, I know the table's not round, so you don't need to make that comment. I get it. But welcome to the roundtable. We are here in Sweden, hanging out with the guys at FX Air Guns, and Fredrik Axelsson here was nice enough to let us in his house. And then we moved around all the furniture. So he's super happy.
Literally.
We're having a great time. We've been talking air guns, and we just decided we had to sit down by the fire and have a roundtable discussion. So today, here's what I want to talk about. We talked about this a little bit earlier, but so many guns now come with power adjusters. You can turn it up, you can turn it down. First of all, I want to talk about a lot of things, but I'm going to start. What's the advantage of being able to crank the power of a gun up and down from the outside when you get it?
Yeah. And accuracy in the rifle, people always think is the barrel. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the barrel is part of it. But if you can find the perfect power combo with that specific barrel and that specific pellet,
sure, because the weight,
it's a lot of variables there.
Yeah.
But it's absolutely durable to get absolute maximum out of your rifle.
Well, on top of manufacturers, we shoot different pellets, weights, sizes, and there's that subtle difference where you got to be able to fine-tune it. You got to find that harmony with what accuracy and with what pellet you're shooting.
Guru, I want to ask you, what's the best way for someone out there that has a gun, what's the best way to find the perfect pellet, weight, and power combination when you get a rifle that is adjustable?
All right. Assume you have a .22 caliber and you want to fine-tune 18 grain.
Mm-hmm.
All right. In a factory, they fine-tune this particular caliber and pellet at a certain distance, right? They shoot it and make sure it's shooting really tight group. Now, if you want to experiment, you want to raise up the notch in velocity and mm-hmm. find out where it would start opening up. And you find your limitation in accuracy according to speed.
Mm-hmm.
So
okay.
I would set the regulator as a certain, let's say 120 bars, right? Your valve adjuster on impact, you have it on level 4, and your power wheel on max. All right, you keep shooting it till you get the maximum velocity where the regulator is providing. Then you adjust your valve adjuster in the front till you hear the harmonic and it's not wasting air. You feel it toning down and the speed is starting to drop a little bit. Then you take your grouping and see how tight it is.
Yeah, I can say something there.
That sounds very complicated.
Did that just go over your head?
It is not complicated when you know what you're doing.
Yeah.
When you're adjusting the valve knobs in the front there, what you're doing is stopping a lot of wasting air because the air is faster than the pellet. And if you have a lot of air surrounding the pellet,
mm-hmm.
if you have the tiniest shake in the pellet, in the muzzle end, you're going to see it down the range. So it's so many things. And a lot of times people say, oh, it's bad barrel and things like that. And mm-hmm. it's very rare is the barrel's problem. They just overpower the gun. You know, you have a curve, you're adjusting, and then you come to that point.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say that 900 feet per second as an example. And then you go higher on the hammer spring, higher and higher. You're not getting more speed, you're just wasting more and more air.
Mm-hmm.
And actually here, you're wasting so much air, it's like crazy, but you're not getting any speed.
Mm-hmm.
It's just going down.
It's creating turbulence, it's shaping it, yeah.
And the accuracy is gone. And what people have done through the years is they have adjusting them too powerful. And too powerful, that's the wrong word. They actually adjust them wrong. So you're passing that curve
mm-hmm.
and going that way. And if you're on that way, on that power, accuracy is completely gone. You have to be 99% of full power. If you're on that side of that curve, you're going to have an amazing gun. Amazing.
Mm-hmm.
And if people just realize that, the sound go down, the efficiency going up,
mm-hmm.
it's just amazing.
It's a sweet spot.
Is there a rule of thumb, like more power, heavier pellet, lighter power, lighter pellet, less power? Is there anything, or no, is it always different?
No, you have to do your tests. You got to start high and work yourself down and testing each speed for each group on the way down.
Get your chronograph out so you can measure.
You can graph the groups, which one is tighter according to speed when you take it down.
Right.
When you find the most accurate speed, then you bring the regulator pressure down, hammer spring, the valve adjuster, and tweak it to that particular speed.
And write down your settings when you find it.
And the other thing I find is, as lower I can put the regulator, the better accuracy I'm getting.
Yeah. Really?
Oh, yeah.
There's so many people that just crank the regulator. They think, oh, just crank that up. More pressure, more pressure.
Yeah.
And it's really, harming their accuracy.
But being able to change the regulator is very specific to an FX air gun. That's not something you're going to get in a typical air gun.
Yeah, but it surprised me. So many people crank it up to 150, 160 straight away. And I just, what? I'm never going to do that. If I go into a competition, even on the third caliber, I go down maybe to 125, 130. Yeah. I put the power on 850. I have a gun in super harmony. It's doing exactly the way I want it to do. And that's how to get very, high in the competition.
Let's talk FX specific. I mean, you guys have these guns now that you can change the caliber, you can change the air intake, you can change the pressure, you can change you can literally change everything on these guns. How is someone out there that gets one of these guns supposed to know what to do when they change the caliber and then change the pellet and then go heavier and then go lighter and then change the valve?
Sure.
And
well, the first thing is when you get your gun and whatever caliber you buy, don't mess with it.
No.
Don't mess with it?
Sweden, yes.
I tell you what. Guys, don't mess with it.
Just go shoot.
Let us spend 20 minutes to adjust the gun right.
Yeah.
Sweden has already done that.
We shipped it out.
Yeah.
And so many people just adjusting the power wheel, the first thing they do, not just the power wheel, they just the adjustable screw all the way
out. Because they get excited.
And they're ruining everything. All the hard work we have done is ruining it straight away.
I get it. They're excited. They're works of art. Especially the FX guns, but yeah, you get your caliber, you get the appropriate pellets, just go shoot. And before, and at the point when you do want to change caliber, change, you know, to heavier pellet, stuff like that, record your settings. Mm-hmm. So when you mess it up, you go, oh yeah, I'm at 140, I'm hammer setting 5, I'm this, that.
But you guys give settings for each grain, pellet, caliber when they get the gun, right? So
there's the standard, hey, this is the pellet liner, here's what it's built for. But I mean, things are changing rapidly. You can change the liners, you can put slugs, you can do different things, and that's where you need to educate yourself. You need to spend some time watching some of the videos, the master class, you gotta learn.
Yeah, and also you have to remember, a lot of people love testing.
Mm-hmm. No,
that's part of the fun.
I mean, the most boring challenge thing is when you get all the result. You understand what I mean? The job is done.
Yeah.
And then, what should I do now then? It's a little bit like that.
Sure.
There's still a lot to learn.
So many variables in everything.
And so you guys are still learning as well.
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
There you go, guys. See, don't feel bad about it. I don't. So you don't need to either, because these are the professions and they're still learning. Quick question. If we were going to do rules of thumb, just for basic shooters, new shooters out there, rules of thumb. Ideally, mid-grain pellet in whatever caliber you're using is probably ideal, the best, or heavy or light.
If I'm shooting for distance, I'll go a little bit heavier to buck the wind.
Okay.
If you're reaching out, that's me. King heavies.
I do a lot of testing, all different weights and different speed, and find the one that's the most accurate, and use that.
Hmm. But if you're not going to test it, and you're just going to take our word for it.
Well, some people don't know how to test. It's not a complete test.
Right.
Just like 25 yards, you shoot a sludge. 25 grain, you're shooting like pancake. But they don't go 75, 100, 125 and further on. Certain slugs will open up and start coming in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It gets stabilized.
It was so funny because when we launched the smooth twist barrel, people were saying they were no good. And they were fantastic.
Yeah,
everyone was fantastic. And I was finding people saying it was no good. Mm-hmm. And then I realized they all tested at 20 yards. And a Luther Walter barrel or a high twist rate barrel would beat the smooth twist at 20 yards. But at longer distance, 50 and beyond, the smooth twist was fantastic. But people didn't try them at long distance. They was just trying, if a Luther Walter shooting better at 20 meter, it must be better at 1800.
Sure.
But that's not the case.
Interesting physics.
And it took them years to figure that one out. Mm-hmm. And I couldn't believe it. And I knew, I'm testing everything. I'm testing so much you can't believe it.
I can't believe it, actually. But I can, because you are who you are. Guys, there you go. I tried to get you some generic answers. I tried. I tried to just get a basic rule of thumb answer, and the rule of thumb is you gotta test your gun, test your pellets, test your distances. So I did my best. Enjoy that information. Gentlemen, thank you so much for chit-chatting with me and letting me, filling me in a little bit. I'm getting educated here. I hope you guys are too. From Sweden, that's it for this episode of The Round Table. Thanks for watching American Air Gunner. For more information, go to AmericanAirGunner.com. We'll see you next time. It's just a real bummer. I just want a basic answer, and there's just not one out there.
No.
There's no simple answer.
I mean, you can't keep it simple. Just grab your 16 grain JSB and go shoot and have fun.